Everyone, Paul Richmond here. We are at the Evansville Museum of Arts, History, and Science, and they are busy getting ready for the opening tonight of War Paint. So I'll give you a little preview. Come with me. Thank you everybody for coming tonight. I can't even begin to express how honored I am to see my artwork here in this museum. We arrived yesterday and got a tour, and it's just so incredible. I want to especially thank Brian for all of his support over the years, believing in me and sharing my work with the community here. I also too want to echo his gratitude to Joycelyn for the careful way that she hung all of the work and made it look so good. Lastly, before I start talking about War Paint, I want to thank one other person, and that is Aaron, my friend, who is standing there with the video camera. He's always doing something to help me, so thank you, Aaron. He drove the paintings and did your Hall truck here yesterday, and this wouldn't have been possible without him, so thank you. War Paint is a series that I began a few years ago because I wanted to express a little bit more about who the person is, the subject, their inner struggles. A lot of times with portraiture, you see people kind of putting their best foot forward, or they're showing you a side of themselves that they want you to see. With these paintings, the concept is that the paint that they're applying to themselves represents something maybe that normally goes unseen, something psychological that particular person is going through, wearing it like armor in a way. Now, each piece has a story, but it's not necessarily important that you know every story with every piece. What I really love about art is that everyone kind of brings their own story to it. So many people look at a piece in this collection and identify with it in a way that was completely different than what I originally imagined, and I think that's great. But I will tell you about a few of them, and we'll start with the one that's about halfway down. Beautiful lady putting the purple paint on her face. You all see that? That is Linda Regula, who is here. She was my art teacher. I started taking classes with her when I was 3 years old. This is all kind of her fault because she had to put the paintbrush in my hand back then. So we wouldn't be here tonight. I was always so inspired by the way that she told so much of a story with her own art, and she overcame a lot of obstacles in her childhood in the mountains. Her piece kind of tells that story. But we were talking earlier and we thought it might be kind of fun to put her on the spot, since we do go back a long ways, and just see if she would be willing to come up and maybe tell a few stories herself and plus get me off the hot seat. Okay, so I'm going to have a girl.
Teacher, and I have a son. By the time we get up at 6 o'clock in the morning, he has drawn anywhere from 100 to 200 drawings. And we think he is very interested in art, so could we bring him over? Well, I figured he'd be about 12, 13, 14 years old. Doorbell rang, and I opened the door, and there's a little 3.5-year-old boy standing on my doorstep with his mother. He has really had rubble on here, and the sun was just shining on him, so he's always been my golden child. I didn't know how to tell her no, because this little boy was just looking at me with these big old eyes. And so we went up to my studio, and I was trying to figure out how to tell her no. But as we walked up the steps, I had paintings hanging up the steps, and he would stop on every step and look at the painting, and then he would turn around and look at me and just smile. And by the time we got to the top of the steps, I was lost. So we go in the studio, and she says, well, I can come and bring him once a week, and I can stay with him. And I said, no. If he comes to classes, he has to be here by himself because he has to learn to trust me if I'm going to teach him. And she said, well, I don't know. And I look over at Paul, and he's just big eyes, and he's looking around my studio, and I got paintings from floor to ceiling. And I said, now, if you stay, your mother can't stay with you. And they had never left him with a babysitter or anybody. So we're staying there, and he sort of, his lip starts to tremble, and he kind of is like he's going to cry, and I say, well, now, the only thing is your mother is asked to leave, and here's the telephone. You can call her at any time and tell her to come back and get you. He said, oh. And I said, but if we do, you never come back. He looks over at his mom and he says, bye, mommy. Right before his classes, he would ask his father to take him to the grocery store. At that time, Snow White was his idol. And he would hunt an apple, a perfect apple for me. And he would come to my door and knock on the door, and he would have an apple in his hand, and he'd say, this is for you, my pretty. And I would sometimes, I would take the apple, and I'd take a bite, and then I would swoon down on the floor, and he would just crack up. But sometimes I'd tease him, and I wouldn't take a bite of the apple. And I would go up to the studio, and I'd say, well, now let's get it. And you could tell, he was just antsy. And so finally, I figured getting interested in the art, I had to take a bite of the apple. So I'd take a bite of the apple and I'd just swoon on the floor. And he would just come over at my face and say, wake up, it wasn't poison. So we go back second long ways. We now have a project we work together called We Will Rise Project. We do workshops. We have an online site. And we do workshops with kids that have been bullied out of the schools. They're cutters. They kill themselves. We put them in workshops and we teach them to channel all that angst and all those feelings into the arts. This is our intern. He has been a godsend. He just does whatever we want him to do. And sometimes he grins, sometimes he frowns.
But he always does.
He always does. Yeah. I'm also an author, and he takes my paintings and makes my book covers. We just have a good time, and so we couldn't miss this. Yeah, I've got a million stories.
She'll be happy to tell you.
One of the things that has really been the outcome for me of doing this series is just kind of working with the different models and realizing how much I have in common with people who I might not have otherwise realized. You know, there's so much that we all share in this human experience, and we live in a time when our politicians and leaders are trying to divide us, but war paint for me has really been about kind of recognizing the common struggles that each of us go through. It's been a way for me to acknowledge and celebrate that within each of my friends, and I have a lot of them who came tonight to see the show, so I thought a good way to conclude this would be to ask all of you who were models for the paintings to just trot on over there and stand in front of the piece that is you, and that means you too. You can stop filming, Aaron.
Hi everyone, Paul Richmond here with intern Aaron Anderson.
So formal.
Yes. We are getting ready for an event.